As mobile money transactions grow to over 145 trillion shillings, users have lost billions to fraud. But there is a breather. Bank of Uganda officials have reported a successful fight against fraud. The success is attributed to their relation with digital payment providers, such as telecom companies, to fight fraudsters through enhanced cybersecurity.
We've gone ahead as Bank of Uganda and key stakeholders to educate the public on a regular basis. The providers or the players have also gone ahead to educate the public about safety of their mobile money and how to secure the account that it's safe. I must say we have a consumer protection regulations that guides the payment service providers, and it's very strict. It also asks the providers to be able to educate consumers.
To curb down this threat to the financial sector, mobile phone owners have been urged to verify SIM cards registered under their identification cards, but most importantly, to follow security precautions when performing transactions.
What we saw before, that quite a number of people were registering their SIM cards and giving it out to their brothers, siblings, their relatives, because they lacked national ID. Now the government has come and said, if you are registered not in your names or using a different identification, please go and enhance you, provide for us a national ID so that we have the SIM card registered in your name, but also limiting the number of SIM cards that someone can have, and that is being spearheaded by Uganda Communications Commission.
Relatedly, officials from the Bank of Uganda and the Ministry of Finance have announced the launch of the second five-year National Financial Inclusion Strategy for the period of 2023 to 2028. The new strategy aligns with Uganda's National Development Plan 3 and supports the government's aspiration to transform to the money economy.
The new strategy aims to reduce poverty and promote economic growth through affordable and quality financial services, through expanding the usage of savings, credit, insurance, remittance, pensions, as well as Islamic banking, financial products and services.
Implementation of the first strategy ended in September with significant achievements in account ownership, mainly driven by access to mobile money and increment in formal access points attributed to agent banking services, among others. Report compiled by Juliet Namoya for the news.